Okay, could you tell me where you're from and what you're reenacting here?
We're portraying the WASP, which stands for the Women's Air Service Pilots. They would fly the planes from the factories to the coast so that the men could fly them overseas for combat.
Okay, and how did you get into reenacting this particular unit?
This started with my husband. We had a Willie's Jeep that we restored. And it bloomed from there. We started in 1988 with this and have been just gathering more information and more stuff ever since.
Okay, how do you come about your equipment and your uniforms?
Well, we used to estate sales, garage sales, newspapers, other people, and of course lately, eBay.
It must be an expensive hobby.
Yeah. But it's an investment. Things that we used to buy for $5 and $10 are now $100 and $150. It's a good retirement fund. Yeah.
If she had a footlocker, she would carry whatever necessity-wise that she would need. Would go with her. The flight suits. This is the flight gear. I don't know if it's coming in. The flight gear, the parachutes, the helmets, the goggles, everything that you would have wore if you would have had to jump in a plane and go.
Dress up in their high heels and their.
So you get just the same equipment that the men would get?
Usually, especially when you started out.
Yeah. It was leftovers from the men.
Yeah,
that's why most of the women didn't have anything to fit with.
They haven't got me anything that comes close yet.
Once the women delivered the planes, they were on their own to get back home.
Yeah. So they would take their dress clothes.
Yeah, once they got their wings, then they could wear the flight suits. Uh-huh. And they would have their wings on here. But we're still in training, so
right.
We're not allowed to wear their wings.
Right.
And then they could also get an A2 jacket.
Wow.
Something we should be on the airplane. Sign the dock for their security training squad.